What's going on, everybody? It's Mike from Dungeons & Diving. Today I want to provide an update to my 2019 video discussing the media offline error in DaVinci Resolve. I'll discuss two options for obtaining the right codecs, a conversion option, and lastly a couple questions regarding DaVinci Resolve itself. Since I can get pretty detailed, all sections will be bookmarked so you can skip to the information you're interested in by clicking at the timeline at the bottom of the video. As many have mentioned in the comments from our previous video, Microsoft codec was no longer a freebie. Sometime in 2020, it was put behind an OEM code and was blocking us from installing it without paying the 99 cents to Microsoft. However, I was recently told that the free codec was available to be installed again. So I personally verified that it does in fact work as of September 2022. So if you came here just for the codec link, click that subscribe button, leave a comment, and grab that link from the video description down below. For those of you that want to understand what the codec does, check out the original video as it goes into some details about codecs and how to check if your hardware can support. If you came here looking for info on troubleshooting the media offline error, as the video title suggests, and want to know what you're doing, sit back and enjoy the video. The first step in fixing the problem we have in DaVinci Resolve is to determine the actual root cause of it. So as you can see on the screen, I've got three videos up here, nothing in my media pool. First thing we need to do is we create this new project in Resolve, and we're going to import some videos. In this case, I'm importing three. What you should expect is that when pressing the play button, after adding it to the timeline, you will see this media offline. However, you should start hearing some audio. You can hear the audio is playing just fine. If you do not have any audio playing at all, your issue probably will not be solved simply by installing this codec. For that scenario, drop a comment down below. I'll be happy to help you out. For those of you that were able to hear the audio like I did, we will get into the options available for you. The best solution is going to be to grab that free HEVC codec while it's still available. To do that, I've provided the link down below in the video description. Head down there and click the link. It'll take you to the Microsoft Store website where you can click on the blue Get in Store app button. Once you click that button, the Microsoft Store will open up, and this should work for both Windows 10 and Windows 11. And you'll see that it comes right to an install option. Click that install option. It's going to start your download. And once this download is complete, you will be all set. If you have issues at that point, and you are actually dealing with a codec issue, uninstall and reinstall DaVinci Resolve, as sometimes it might not detect the new codec was installed. Otherwise, drop a comment below and let me know what's going on to see if you're dealing with a different problem. The first alternative I'm going to show you, and the one that I recommend if that free codec is blocked by Microsoft again, is to simply purchase the HEVC codec pack from Microsoft for 99 cents, or whatever the equivalent price is if you're outside the United States. The reason I recommend this option is due to regular updating by Microsoft via the Windows updates and the store updates. We'll dive deeper into this in just a few moments. The second option I'm going to speak about is one I do not recommend unless you're an extremely tech-savvy person and you're okay with the risks involved. There are sites on the internet that are hosting this exact HEVC codec, and I've downloaded one and looked at it from a binary analysis perspective. While the one I grabbed seems legit, I have a couple of problems with obtaining this codec in this manner. First, depending on the local laws where you live, you risk running into legal concerns about downloading the codec outside the store. Secondly, this is considered software piracy, and even though it's only 99 cents, my stance is simply don't do it. Especially when the codec might even be free. For those reasons, I will not be providing links to the third-party websites as I do not advocate for these illegitimate options, whether it's free or 99 cents. My biggest reason for this is that cybersecurity is a major issue. While downloading third-party sites might provide the same package as the Windows Store, there's no updating mechanism in place for these third-party sites. In order to update the codecs from them, you would need to check for updates and apply them to your system manually. Also, you need to do a manual inspection of the codec pack every single time you install it to make sure there's no malware embedded in the file itself. For illustrative purposes, the file you download is a compressed folder with code that actually installs unknown and potentially malicious software, and not necessarily the codecs you wanted. In my case, it installed the codecs. In your case, I can't guarantee it either way. Can you see how this might be a problem? Especially if you don't know how to perform the analysis on it? Drop a comment, I'll be happy to elaborate further. Lastly, there are two other issues that seem to be more frequent in the comments from my previous video. There are issues using DaVinci Resolve with HEVC, and folks that are using older computers for editing. First, going back to DaVinci Resolve 17, some of the comments stated that with version 17, this fix didn't work. I tested it out on various machines, and Resolve 17 and newer work just fine with the Windows Store version of the HEVC codec, both the free and the paid version. If this codec doesn't fix your issue, then you must look for other root causes. Drop me a comment, and again, I'll gladly help out as time permits. Second, for people with older hardware, you have to keep in mind HEVC compression takes quite a bit of CPU horsepower. If your older CPU can't handle the processing in real time, you're not going to be able to edit HEVC videos very efficiently. Your best option would be to convert videos to a less compressed form, such as H.264, whereas HEVC is H.265, so it's just one iteration newer. However, H.264 does take less CPU horsepower. My preferred conversion software for this is Handbrake. It does a great job, but most importantly, it is free and open source. There's an active community that provides updates, new features, and support when needed. Also, being open source means you can go over to GitHub and you can inspect the source code, submit your own updates, and help patch any vulnerabilities or even provide optimizations if you find them. At this point, if you're still having issues, there are a few things you need to consider. Check to make sure that you have the minimum specs or greater for HEVC and your editor. I'll drop a link below that shows the supported processors. Second, if you're using DaVinci Resolve, check to ensure you have audio playing as well as seeing the media offline error. If you do, it's most likely codec or install related. After installing the codec, you should try to complete uninstall and reinstall Resolve if you're in that situation. All else fails, you can convert your videos to a lower compressed version, meaning H.264. Pro tip, if you're converting with Handbrake and don't want to wait for the conversion, queue up your videos to be converted and run it when you go to bed. The last thing I'd like to talk about is if you need to uninstall the codec for any reason. Most Windows Store apps can be uninstalled from the store itself. This codec is not quite as easy. In order to uninstall it, you need to run a couple of commands via PowerShell. So the first step you're going to do is you're going to run PowerShell from the Windows Start menu, but you need to run it as administrator. You're going to go ahead and click on this warning that allows it to change your device. You're going to see it's a weird blue window here. The next step is to look for the installed codec by running this command on the screen. It's going to be get-AppxPackage pipe select name, comma, package full name, non-removable. And don't worry, I'll put this down below so you can just copy and paste it as well. What that's going to do is it's going to list a lot of the packages that are installed. And what you're going to want to do is you want to look for where it says Microsoft.HEVC video extension. Now, this is not what we really need. We need this side of the house. And in order to do this removal, it's going to be really simple. The next step we need to do is remove-AppxPackage. And then you're going to highlight this and then just copy and paste it right there. And that will instantly remove it from your system. Now, I'm going to reinstall that, but if you head at section, we'll have the actual script to do this. And to wrap everything up, if your hardware supports it, grab the HEVC codec from the Windows Store, either free or $1 if Microsoft blocks it again. If you're editing videos on older hardware, convert the old videos to something your hardware can work with using a tool like Handbrake. And lastly, if this video helped solve your issues, I'd greatly appreciate it if you took the time to like and sub, as it helps get this information to others who are looking for it. Thanks for watching, and happy editing.